Welcome to Kids Choice Book Show on KZI 88.7 FM. Today my guest is K.A. Holt, author of Knockout, which is a sequel to House Arrest, written for middle schoolers. In House Arrest, the main character, Timothy, steals a wallet to help his baby brother who is sick. Then Timothy is put on house arrest. The book explores Timothy's life under house arrest. Next, in the book, Knockout, it introduces you into Levi's life while Timothy lives with him and the new drama in his life. K.A. Holt has written 8 books for middle school students and received the Amazon Best Book for Student and Teens Award and a Bank Street Best Book of the Year Award. Thanks so much for coming on.
Thank you for having me.
What is House Arrest and Knockout about?
Book finishes. It's the end of Timothy's journal. And when I was writing it, that's just how I figured the story would end. You know, you get to the last page of your journal and you're at the last page of your journal. But a lot of people were very angry with me about the way that House Arrest ended. And so Knockout then was conceived as Levi's story, which Levi's the little baby in House Arrest. And so when Knockout starts, it's 12 years in the future and Levi is in the 7th grade. And he's no longer a sick baby, but Timothy and his mother treat him like he's still a sick baby. And so Knockout is about Levi's relationship with them and him trying to just grow older without being stifled by his mom and his brother. And it's about his relationship with his dad. And in House Arrest, Timothy is very much not a fan of his dad's because his dad has left them. And so we get to see Timothy and Levi working through their new relationship with their dad in Knockout.
What inspired you to make a sequel for your first book, House Arrest?
So I had never really thought that I was going to write a sequel. And like I said, a lot of people were mad at me about the end of House Arrest. And I sat down to pick it up right where House Arrest ended. And I just couldn't figure out how to do that because I felt like I had told Timothy's story. But then a friend of mine was like, "Dummy, we don't know what happened to Levi. You've left us hanging with Levi." And so what I did in writing Knockout is that I wanted to be not necessarily a sequel, but a companion. So technically, if you wanted to, like if you hadn't read House Arrest, you could read Knockout first and then read House Arrest second. So that way they come in any order and you're coming at the stories on your own in different places, which I think is cool. So I like the idea that that they're companions.
Do you think there might be a third book in the House Arrest universe, like you told me before?
Yes, I know. In fact, there will be one because I emailed my revision to my editor today, and that one doesn't have a title yet, and it'll be out next fall. And that one is the story of Levi's best friend Tam in Knockout. So Levi will be a minor character in this next book, and you'll get to see Tam and Kate's story in the new one.
Why did you want Levi to describe how he boxed in repetition using words like beat or drum and hum?
Well, because I'm a huge fan of onomatopoeia, and onomatopoeia is when you use sounds in your poetry. And I had to learn to box to write this book. And so while I was, you know, learning how to move my feet, it really felt like dancing to me. It was a little bit like a dance, and that kind of beat I really liked. It worked with dancing. It works with the rhythm of poetry. It's fun, you know. If you read it out loud, it's fun. So that's why I did that.
What do you think the book teaches kids and preteens?
What does it teach them? I think what it teaches them is that it's okay to be a little rebellious. I think it teaches them that if you are a little rebellious, don't be surprised if there are consequences to your actions. I think it teaches them about how friendships change over time and how that can be really hard, but it's something that everybody goes through. And I think it talks talks about like relationship that you have with your family, like your parents and your siblings, and how those change like as you get older, and how that can be both a really great thing and also a challenge.
When I read the book, I felt happy and surprised. What emotion did you want the readers to feel?
I'm glad that you felt happy and surprised, because I wanted you to feel that. I wanted this to be a less sad book than House Arrest was. Not that I think House Arrest is terribly sad, but I wanted this to be more on a manic peak, right? Like jumpy and happy and noisy and dancy, and watching Levi, like this little happy boy, come into his own. So I wanted people to feel that way, and I want my readers to see themselves in Levi, and to see the success that he has in like breaking out of his shell and teaching his mom and his brother that, you know, he'll be okay even in a big scary world.
How do you think the book would be if Tam, who is Levi's best friend, never met Kate, who is also Tam's new best friend, who made Levi feel like she was stealing his friendship with Tam?
So when you're writing, one of the things that you need is conflict, right? Like, you could write a story with no conflict, but it would be sort of a boring story. And so you have to have something that has this push-pull to it. And I needed a way for Levi to have to experience things on his own so that he couldn't always depend on Tam to be there for him. And the best way that I could think to do that was to have Tam have this new friend. And it's not really that Levi can't be friends with Kate or that Kate can't be friends with him. It's just the two of them like Tam so much that they immediately feel competitive with each other. And I think that that's kind of a realistic thing. So I wanted there to be a reason for Levi to have to kind of set out on his own into the big wide world and figure things out by himself.
Why didn't Levi understand why Timothy was always studying for tests and being around him and his mom? And also, Timothy is Levi's older brother.
Yes, well, you have to think, like, in Levi's life, Timothy has always been there all the time. Timothy is his much older brother, and so he's been kind of a surrogate father, right? And Timothy also has been very overprotective, like always making sure that Levi is healthy and that he's got the medicine that he needs and he's, you know, healthy and okay. And so now that Timothy has decided to go to medical school, or to try to get into medical school, he has to study for his tests, and it's just completely weird for Levi to not have Timothy around, right? Not only is Tam not around, but now Timothy is not around, and he's kind of floundering a little bit. His protective layer is eroded a bit.
Why do you think Levi depended on Timothy so much? But not because like Timothy helped Levi when he was a sick baby, but maybe something else.
Well, I think that Levi has sort of been under house arrest his whole life, just as a baby. And so Timothy is not only a caretaker for him, but like one of his best friends, you know, and someone that, even though he's his brother, that he has been able to open up to and talk to about his feelings and what's going on. And you know, having Timothy not as available to him is hard, because he does see him as kind of a buddy.
How do you think Timothy, Levi's older brother, has evolved from the first book, House Arrest?
Well, when House Arrest starts, Timothy is just very angry. He's angry that his dad has left, he's angry that his brother is sick, he's angry that his mom is having so much trouble taking care of them. He's just a really angry kid. And as House Arrest progresses, he learns how to channel that anger in better ways. And I think that when we get to Knockout, Timothy is in his 20s, and he has spent time in a juvenile detention facility for some of those anger issues that he had. And he's a little more of a grown-up now, and he has better ways of dealing with things. And I think he learned in house arrest that keeping a journal is very important. It's a great way to write out how you're feeling and to kind of come to terms with things that are happening in your life. And so we see in Knockout that Timothy continues to keep a journal, and I think that that's an important thing. is to learn how to talk about your feelings.
In the book, Levi's dad lets Levi do boxing behind his mom's back. His dad didn't know that it was probably the wrong thing to do, but it was a risk for Levi getting injured since he had something, like he had a throat thing. I'm not sure how to explain it.
Right. So when Levi was a baby, he had a condition called subglottic stenosis, where he ended up with a tracheostomy, which is a tube in your neck to help you breathe. And when Knockout starts, we find out he doesn't have the tube in his neck anymore. He's had surgery, and he can breathe through his nose and his mouth now. But everybody in his family is still pretty worried about this. But Levi's dad was not living with them while all this stuff was happening. And so it isn't that big of a deal, right? Like, he wasn't there to see all these times when Levi as a baby couldn't breathe and had the surgery and all this stuff. And so he really, really wants Levi to be like a bigger, stronger kid. You know, he wants him, you know, be a man, we're gonna teach you how to be a man. And Levi wants to please his dad, you know, and he's a little excited that he can do something that his mom and his brother don't know about, right? Like, his little secret that he has, and that to him is appealing, even though it's kind of scary, the idea of doing boxing, like, yikes, because he's such, like, this, you know, tiny little dude.
How long did it take you to write Knockout?
It took me about 18 months, I would say, to write Knockout from beginning to end and have a final copy.
Thanks, Kay Hull, author of Knockout, for coming on. I'm your host, Maya Hay, and thanks for listening to Kids' Choice Book Show on Below Zero on KZI 88.7 FM.